about a beautiful land which you many people think, many people have the wrong perception about it. So I am going to talk about Bastar, which I say that it is an unexplored land. It is a place where many people don't know about what actually is happening over there in Bastar. They think that this Bastar is a land where Naxal and rebellions live. The land where people think that they will find at each corner of the road, they will find a person with a gun fighting with an army person or killing common people. Other people have the perception that there will be tribes with bows and arrows, and any outside people who will come, any stranger who will come there, they will kill that guy. But whatever I said, is it true? Is it true that Bastar is a land of Naxals? Sorry to say that I don't agree upon all the previous thoughts. I born in Bastar, I am from Bastar, and I love my land. This is the reason why I am talking in front of you. Bastar is the land which is blessed with nature. It is a land where you can see the India's widest waterfall, which is Chitkut waterfalls. It is a place where you can see Tiragarh waterfalls, which makes a very beautiful three waterfalls in a single waterfall. It is a place where you see the seismic view like this. It is a place where you can find the highest waterfall, which is famed after shooting, some sort of shooting happened for the Bahubali part 2. And this seismic view, if you find, we have Keshkar Valley, we have forest, we have Kutumsar Cave. You will be surprised to know that we have approximate 50 above caves in Bastar region. And we just know 2 or 3. So that kind of an unexplored place I am living. If I will not say anything about tribes, its tribes, the talk will be incomplete. So we have the indigenous tribes, the Gonds, the Madias, the Muryas, and n number of tribes reside over there. And also, Bastar is the land of history and mythology. Lord Rama, during his exile time, came here and spent time at Bastar. We have the longest festival of the world, Bastar Dashera. You are surprised to know that it is celebrated for approximate 75 days. Bastar is a place where every person is participating in the development. We have roads, we have proper infrastructure, we have industries with us, but what is the problem? Why still people afraid coming to Bastar? The reason is negative perception, negative branding, which is continuously done by international media, national media, local media itself, and people are buying it. people are going on a flow that this is a land of Naxals. This is a, you will be killed by going there. You'll have to carry ID card. People will check you thoroughly. And all those things. This is the negative perception about Bastar. I traveled across Bastar to the various interior destinations, but I have not seen a single Naxal in my whole life. So, first of all, I would say that this is a negative branding about Bastar. The second thing which I want to talk about is there are very, as we know that negative things says like a hot cake. But when I say positive thing, it will slowly reach to the person. So there are, this is what we are lacking with. There are less awareness on recent development which has happened in a decade or so. Apart from which, we are lacking positive voices. We are especially lacking positive voices who can say that, no, this is a real problem. By keeping all this thought, what has happened? I'll go to my college days. I'll go back to my college days. At the time when I was first time I went to some big city was Hyderabad. I went to Hyderabad for getting a job of call center, but I was not able to get the job. But the people, when I say people, that I am from Bastar. Okay, you are from Bastar. Why you are not wearing langot? Where is your langot? How come you are wearing these clothes? I thought, okay, sir, this is the thing that we wear proper clothes. This happened till date. This happened till date. When I say Bastar, oh, where is the gun? Oh, where is your bow and arrows? Oh, what you are wearing? I thought, oh, I'll have to do something for it. Then when I was doing my MBA, at that time, I started a thought in my mind that I should do something for my Bastar because I love my Bastar. And whatever the people are saying is not the correct thing. So I thought I should be focusing upon something which can impact a lot. So I thought tourism is a best way to promote Bastar positively, because tourism has multiplier effect. If a tourist comes to any place, first of all, branding will happen. That yes, this place is very good. The second thing which will happen is it will going to give livelihood to many people, like transporter, like the hotel, resort, or homestays, like the tourist will eat something, the local livelihood will increase. So I thought that this is the thing which I focus upon. Then I started a page on social media, which is named as Unexplored Bastar. Till date, we are only sharing positive news about Bastar, especially Bastar tourism. We wanted, when I started, I met with many like-minded people like me, like Jitin Nakka, Ashish Gadpate was there. So we started making Unexplored Bastar as a platform to engage the crowd, helping people, removing their perception about Bastar, and many things we started doing. So we got a very good response because we were the first social media platform where we share our thoughts. We talked about Bastar tourism, we talked about history, its tribes, and many things we talked about. Whatever experiences I had, I started putting in my thoughts. I took 3 months sabbatical leave from the organization and 3 more months. In 6 months, I prepared a plan. It was a social entrepreneurship concept I started working on. So what I tried to do is, Chhattisgarh Tourism Board and other government department is working in another direction, and other service providers are working in some certain other direction. So I tried to, in a one platform, I tried to aggregate them. I tried to aggregate them with the support of government, district administration. Because we are lucky to have Mr. Amit Kataria, our collector, with us. He is supporting in each and every tourism related activity. So what we tried to do is, first of all, I connected with the right people, the like-minded people who have some sort of passion about Bastar. We started connecting with the right people and we formed the team. We formed the team and then we started using social media platform. We started promoting Bastar tourism, Bastar, hashtags. We made hashtags, we tagged people around us. We did so many things by using social media. Then we continuously tried to do is competitions, photography competition. So we invite people from across India to come to Bastar, photograph it and publish it, write a blog and just promote it. Then the most important thing which we did is we started organizing tracking tours at interior unexplored destination, which is called as the Naxal hotbed. We started organizing that tracking and tours to that locations. So all these things we have done to change the perception of people. The next thing we did is capacity building. We started giving training with the help of Arya Prerana Samiti. We started giving training to people and training, because capacity, if you are going there and if person is don't know how to handle you, how to give proper service, the tourism will fail. So it was very important to connect the livelihood of local people. To promote any, to develop any tourism, we have to have a proper mechanism in place. So what we did is, we started giving training to many people. We are continuously doing it. And we are promoting indigenous cultural tourism because it has so much of scope. Apart from it, to connect the livelihood of people, we started promoting homestays. So if you want to stay at the at very deep down the jungle, you will not have to afraid. You just have to go there, you will find some homestay over there. Then if you go and stay there, they generate the livelihood through Bastar food and Bastar dances, which is very famous. The Dami Maria dances are very famous. So the food they eat, you will not find any tribe with diabetes. You will not find any person with cancer, because they eat the food which is very, very, very organic. So what we tried to do is, in the package, we tried to fit Bastar dance and Bastar food so that the people start using the organic food. The problem which we were facing was, we required a place so that we can do the brainstorming. So I connected with the people. There were many people who can contribute to this Bastar tourism, but we needed a common place. Then the thought of Amcho Bastar came. So Amcho Bastar Bazaar, as she said, that this place is, we are using it in two ways. If a person who is coming to Bastar whatever products which is produced or manufactured in Bastar by the rural people, they'll get there. Second thing what we did is we started making it a happening place where we can do tourism related activities. The brainstorming session comes to an end and we finalize upon what things we will be focusing upon. Before we start focusing upon infrastructure development, if a tourist comes to any place, we require basic amenities over there with proper road and service, proper road and telecommunication. So we started putting pressure on the government to have all those things in place. Then we started working on the conservation of archaeological sites, because as I said that we have history and we have mythological stories with us. So we started conservation of archaeological sites. Then we are focusing upon ecotourism, because Bastar is a land which has forest in and around. So we are developing ecotourism, then the cultural tourism. So many things has happened in just 6 months. So many things. I was not able to put many slides, but yes, we have done many things, we have achieved many things. How? I'm not a motivational speaker, but what I believe in actions. I believe in action. What I did, I showcased. But the thing which required is the passion. The passion to change, to do something good for the society, to do something which will be remembered when you will not have this body with you, to do something which will actually benefit your peace. Thanks so much.